The pitot tube is a small but essential part of an aircraft that plays a major role in aviation safety. Without it, pilots would lose access to one of their most critical flight instruments,
the airspeed indicator.
This device measures how fast an aircraft is moving through the air, making it vital for safe takeoffs, landings, and smooth flight operations. In this video by Epic Flight Academy, we'll explain what a pitot tube is, how it works, where it's located on an aircraft, and why it's such a crucial component in today's aircraft systems. If you're passionate about aviation or training to become a pilot or aircraft mechanic, be sure to like and subscribe to Epic Flight Academy for more expert aviation content. Let's get started.
My name's Josh Rawlins. I'm the Chief Operating Officer at Epic Flight Academy. The pitot tube is an instrument that hangs off of the aircraft in different locations depending on the aircraft. What it does is it indicates airspeed for the pilot inside the aircraft.
The science behind measuring fluid flow began in the 18th century with two major discoveries. Italian physicist Giovanni Battista Venturi observed that fluid speeds up and pressure drops when passing through a narrow section of a pipe, a concept known as the Venturi effect, based on Bernoulli's principle, which states that as fluid velocity increases, pressure decreases. The Venturi tube uses this effect to measure flow rate and has been used in aviation for carburetors, vacuum systems, and older airspeed indicators. Around the same time, French engineer Henri Pitot invented the pitot tube to measure water velocity. It was later adapted for aviation to measure airspeed by capturing stagnation pressure. This innovation led to the modern pitot-static system, now critical for accurate airspeed data. Pilots check it before every flight, and mechanics regularly inspect it to ensure safe operation. While the Venturi tube measures flow rate and the pitot tube measures airspeed, both rely on fluid dynamics and pressure changes.
It's a little tube, and the air pressure as you fly is ramming into that tube, and it's pushing on a little diaphragm to move a gauge. The airspeed indicator is your primary instrument that relies on the pitot tube. Once you get into the pitot-static system, then you start getting into other instruments that use some of that data as well.
There are several types of pitot tubes suited for different applications and aircraft types. Standard pitot tubes are found in general aviation aircraft like the Cessna Skyhawk. Prandtl pitot tubes incorporate both pitot and static ports. Dwyer flow meters use HVAC and industrial flow measurement. Military and airline pitot tubes are designed for high-speed jets and commercial aircraft. The difference between these gives the dynamic pressure, used to calculate airspeed with the formula, total pressure minus static pressure. Although the pitot tube itself has no sensors, it's connected to pressure sensors that provide real-time readings. Some pilots even use online tools to calculate flow velocity using total pressure, static pressure, or air density. This pressure comparison is the core principle behind how pitot tubes measure speed during flight. On aircraft like the Cessna Skyhawk, the pitot tube is mounted near the nose, under a wing, or beside the cockpit.
This is the cover, so this keeps any kind of bugs or debris or water from getting in it while the aircraft's sitting on the ground. It has this red flag on it so the pilot sees it and ensures they take it off. The cover comes off. This is the pitot tube itself. You can see the small hole in the front of it where the air is allowed to ram into the tube. But if you notice, the tube is out here. There's nothing in front of it. There's no obstructions. It's not behind the path of the propeller. On some aircraft, the pitot tubes are on the fuselage, but that's typically when the engines are out on the wings.
With regular flight operations, aircraft can collect dirt, insects, or even ice, which can block pitot tubes and static ports. These blockages can lead to inaccurate airspeed or altitude readings, posing serious risks during takeoff, landing, or poor weather conditions.
One of the really common things we see here in Florida we look out for are little bugs. They're actually called mud daubers, and they'll make a home basically and lay their eggs inside the tube because it's the right size hole. And there's a lot of little bugs that do that, that lay their eggs in. So they'll actually climb inside there and build stuff up, and you won't see anything from the outside, any indication that they're there, until you actually look down inside the tube. So
A clogged pitot tube may display false airspeed, while a blocked static port can distort altitude readings or trigger false stall warnings. To avoid this, many aircraft, including Epic Cessna Skyhawks, use heated pitot tubes that prevent ice buildup and help ensure reliable airspeed data for safe flight. Our students study real-world accidents involving pitot-static system failures to better understand these hazards and enhance future flight safety. One example our students study is Bergen Air Flight 301, which crashed into the ocean in the Dominican Republic on February 6, 1996, shortly after takeoff. This accident resulted in 189 fatalities. The Boeing 757-200 had not flown in 20 days, and someone removed the pitot tube cover 2 days before the flight. Investigators reported a wasp nest built inside one of the tubes blocked the airflow, causing pilots to read an incorrect airspeed. Air France Flight 447 is another accident our students study. This airliner crashed into the ocean on June 1, 2009 on its way to France, resulting in 228 deaths. The final report found that ice crystals probably blocked the pitot tubes of the Airbus A330-203, causing incorrect airspeed readings and leading the autopilot to shut off. When it comes to following safety protocols prior to scheduled flights, safety is key. Pitot tubes typically last between 5 to 10 years, depending on factors like aircraft usage, environmental conditions, material quality, and maintenance. They're not usually replaced due to age alone, but are swapped out when damaged, clogged, or worn during inspections. On commercial and training aircraft, frequent checks help ensure they're reliable and replaced as needed. Despite their importance, pitot tubes have some drawbacks. They can be prone to clogging, have limited accuracy in extreme flow conditions, and are vulnerable to vibration damage. Maintaining the pitot-static system is a key part of aviation safety. At Epic's FAA Part 147 Aircraft Mechanic Program, students gain hands-on experience learning how the system works. They're trained to inspect, clean, and test pitot tubes and static ports, check for blockages, verify pitot heat function, perform leak tests, read schematics, and troubleshoot issues. They also learn to recognize signs of system failure and calibrate instruments for accuracy. Since the pitot-static system directly affects the airspeed indicator, altimeter, and vertical speed indicator, this training is essential.
Every 24 calendar months, the pitot-static system has to be tested and calibrated to make sure it's within limits. So that's something we do to all of our aircraft. We put these special gauges on them. It's basically a calibrated instrument for altimeter and airspeed, and we make sure that everything matches and make sure we don't have any leaks or anything like that, and recalibrate and adjust.
The pitot tube may be small, but it plays a critical role in aviation safety by providing accurate airspeed data, something every pilot depends on. From its origins in fluid dynamics to its modern use in the pitot-static system, this simple device is essential for safe and reliable flight. With proper maintenance, heating systems to prevent ice, and careful pre-flight checks, the pitot tube helps ensure that aircraft systems function correctly in all conditions. If you found this breakdown of the pitot tube helpful, be sure to check out our other videos on aircraft systems, pilot training, and aviation technology. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and keep learning how everything comes together to keep planes flying safely from Epic Flight Academy.